Apostle Paul's role in Christianity. There is no Christianity without Paul. This message is for those who question the apostleship of Saint Paul and think that Paul was a false apostle and he contradicts the teachings of Jesus Christ. There was Christianity before Apostle Paul, but after him there was no Christianity without him. In the beginning, Apostle Paul, whose name was Saul, was a persecutor of the church and an enemy of Christians. One day Lord Jesus appeared to him while he was on the road to Damascus. This changed his life and he became one of the greatest disciples of Jesus Christ. Chosen and appointed by God to be an apostle of Jesus Christ, Lord Jesus gave him visions and revelations and appeared to him in visions and spoke to him and worked through him all his lifetime. Paul is to the church as was what the prophets were to the Israelites. As God was with Moses giving the law and commandments and instructions through him for the Israelites, the Lord gave guidance and instructions to the churches through Paul, which are all explained in his epistles to the churches. From the time Lord Jesus appeared to Paul on his way to Damascus, that's in Acts chapter 9, and to the very end of his life, Jesus was with Paul. Paul did not make up anything on his own. Whatever he taught the church was what he received from the Lord. No one can be a follower of Jesus Christ unless and until he or she fully accepts the teachings of Apostle Paul. There was Christianity before Paul, but after him there is no Christianity without him. Apostle Paul in his epistles to the Galatians wrote like this: "But even if we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel to you than what we have preached to you, let him be accursed." Galatians chapter 1 verse 8 and 9. This "we" here in this verse includes the other apostles who were the disciples of Jesus Christ. In Acts chapter 15, an account is given of how Apostle James, Peter and all the elders gathered together in Jerusalem when Barnabas and Paul visited them and what decision they made with the help and guidance of the Holy Spirit in matters concerning the Gentiles being circumcised and they observing the law of Moses and all that. Apostle Paul approved the writings of Paul, which he wrote by the revelation from God. From Acts chapter 9 throughout the rest of the book, the Lord's presence and guidance in Paul's life and ministry is evident. After his first encounter with Jesus in chapter 9, the Lord again appeared to him several times. Acts chapter 9 verses 5 and 6, chapter 18 verse 9, chapter 22 verse 17 through 21, chapter 23 verse 11. The Lord, as he was with the disciples while he was in the flesh, was with Paul in the spirit. The Holy Spirit's dealings and guidance can also be found in other chapters like Acts chapter 13 verse 2 through 4, chapter 15 verse 18, chapter 16 verse 6, 18, 5, chapter 19 verse 6, 20 verse 23, chapter 21 verse 4 through 11. God sent an angel to strengthen Paul when the ship that carried him to Rome was caught up in the storm. God gave him great revelations of the scriptures like no other received. Once he was taken up into the third heaven, there were some in the early church that opposed Paul and tried to discredit him. But Paul received the support of other apostles and his teachings discredited and silenced those who opposed him. Other apostles received Barnabas and Paul graciously and gave the right hand of fellowship to them. Later, Apostle Peter approved the writings of Paul which he received by revelation and rebuked those who misinterpreted what Paul wrote. It was Apostle Paul who made known to the church how Jesus came and fulfilled the law and the prophets. God was pleased to reveal to him the hidden mysteries of the scripture. Some people argue that Paul contradicts the teachings of Jesus Christ. Not knowing what they are talking about, they quote from Matthew chapter 5 verses 17 and 18 and from Paul's writings in his epistles. Lord Jesus told that he came not to destroy the law but to fulfill them. In all his epistles, Apostle Paul explains how Lord Jesus fulfilled the law and the prophets. Not only that, but he also explained what this scripture in the Gospel of John means. The law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. John chapter 1 verse 17. Paul explains how this grace that brought faith works and what faith is all about, and how faith operates in the life of a believer. Apostle Paul said that by the works of the law, no man can be saved. Lord Jesus himself once told the Jews, "Did not Moses give you the law? Yet none of you keeps the law." John 7. When Lord Jesus told the crowd that brought the woman caught in adultery, "He who is without sin among you, let him throw a stone at her first." John 8:8. There was no one among them without sin. Those who heard it, being convicted by their conscience, went out one by one, beginning with the oldest even to the last. No one would have known what the gifts of the Spirit are and how they operate except through the epistles Paul wrote. Apostle Paul explained what are the fruit of the Spirit. He wrote the greatest chapter on charity. He revealed and explained the many great mysteries of God, like the benefits of the new covenant, law of faith, rapture, new creation, sonship of the believers, resurrection, return of Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Communion, spiritual warfare, restoration of Israel, judgment day, etc. Apostle Paul is known as the greatest missionary of all times. With his fellow workers, Paul carried out several missionary journeys and planted many churches in many parts of the world. Later he visited these churches and taught the believers and edified them. The epistles he wrote to these churches remain as the guidelines and standard for all the churches of God until this day. Lord Jesus said about the Holy Spirit, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you." John chapter 14 verse 26. This the Holy Spirit did through Apostle Paul as well as other apostles of Jesus Christ. Those who receive the words of Jesus will also receive the words of Apostle Paul, because Lord Jesus said to the disciples, "If they have kept my saying, they will keep yours also." John 15 verse. Apostle Paul suffered the loss of all things and endured tremendous hardships for the sake of the gospel. From the time Lord appeared to Paul on his way to Damascus to the very end of his life, Jesus was with him. Paul, in his last epistle that he wrote toward the end of his life, wrote to Timothy that even when all the believers turned away from him at a time of crisis, the Lord stood with him and strengthened him to deliver the message boldly. God, who was with Joseph and who gave victory to David wherever he went, was with Paul and always led him in triumph. Paul glorified God by his death as well as his life. There is no Christianity without Paul. If anyone thinks contrary to this, he or she has not known the way of the Lord.